Well, hello there, my fellow Islanders. Welcome back to my channel and to a brand new Fallout 76 video. So in this video, I will be showing you what are the best legendary perks in Fallout 76, in my opinion, as of right now. So before we start, make sure to sub with the notification on, you never miss a video from now on. And without further ado, let us start this video. So the first one, and in my opinion, the best legendary perk in Fallout 76 is the survival shortcut. So basically what this does is it generates a survival aiding chem every 30 minutes up to 5. This is the chem that it produces every 30 minutes. It basically refuels your entire food, water and your health. Just keep in mind, if you have radiation, it doesn't cure the radiation, but it will refuel your health, your food and your water. If you look at my food and my water, they're basically empty, and if I use one of them, it completely refuels both of them. And the best thing about this perk is that you don't even need to level it up, because the rate that your food and hunger drops is lower than 30 minutes. So you usually have maximum amount of them, you usually have 5 of them in your inventory. So basically with having this equipped, you don't need to carry around any more food with you, which opens up about 100 all the way up to 150 points in your weight, which you could carry a lot more things. So this is why, in my opinion, this is the best legendary perk in Fallout 76 as of right now. Definitely have this equipped, it's a game changer. Now for the next one, I suggest Ammo Factory. Ammo Factory will basically help you produce a lot more ammo. I think you all know how hard it is to craft ammo, so having this plus side of Ammo Smith will help you out a lot to craft a lot more ammo. Which, if you can see, I have Ammo Smith at level 2 and the legendary perk at level 3. So each time that I craft 50 cal rounds, I craft 360 rounds instead of just 100. Almost 3 for the cost of 1. So this will help you out, just craft a lot of ammo. You don't need to think about, oh, I'm out of lead, I'm out of steel, what the fuck am I supposed to do? You can do a lot of the harder events like the Callisto Problem or the Scorched Earth more often. It just helps you out a lot. So in my opinion, have this equipped as your second or your third legendary perk. Now for the next perk, I highly suggest using the Master Infiltrator. Now basically what this skill does is at level 1, it auto unlocks skill 0 terminals, which we don't care about this, and locks. What we care about is the plus 3 lockpick and hacking skill. You see, this is the basically only useful part in this perk, because if you have this equipped, it will open up 3 points in your intelligence and 3 points in your perception. So you can equip a lot more perk cards and damage. Instead of using it for the hackers to hack terminal or the lockpick to unlock doors. So we don't really need to level this legendary skill even to 2. It does the trick at 1, but if you really care about having it maxed out and basically auto unlock everything, go for it. But in my opinion, it doesn't worth it. Have it at 1, it will help you out a lot with your build. Now for the next one, I suggest Power Sprinter. You see, if you use power armor a lot like me, with having this perk equipped, you consume less action points. Now you see, the action point is not the important part. What we care about is our fusion cord. You see, whenever you run in your power armor, you consume more of your fusion cord than when you just walk. And it's not based on how much you run, it's based on how much action point you use running. So having this equipped will decrease the amount of fusion core that you use for running. Basically, it doesn't mean that you decrease it, it means that you run further, you use less action points, so you use less fusion core, which means you have to worry about it less. So you know, you don't have to constantly be in a lookout for farming and shit like that. So in my opinion, this is one of those perks that you should consider equipping after like level 200 or so. It's not one of the top ones, but it's something to look at. Now for the last one, I'm actually going to show you what's the worst legendary perk among all of them. The Brawling Chemist. So if you could see, it produces Super Chem Mark 1, which has these effects, plus 30% damage, plus 25 damage resistance, and plus 2 strength. Now you might say to yourself, yo, this is really good, you need this, right? If you're using a melee build, you need this. Well, no, you're stupid, this is shit, let me tell you why. You You see, this is a cycle buff. You could buy the plants from Enclave for like 300 caps or something like that. And basically what it does is plus 25% damage, plus 3 strength, 3 endurance, and 65 max health for 3 minutes. Now you might say to yourself, oh, but the last one said 30%. Well, yes, that's 30% only to your melee damage. But cycle buff does 25% for every gun you're using. You're using a Fatman, you're using heavy weapon, you're using melee, whatever, it doesn't matter. And it does plus 3 strength, not plus 2. So it's basically better in every way you want to look at it. Now if you say, but you want damage resistance, not the strength or the endurance increase, you want to go with psychotats. Now these one, I don't think you could buy a plans for him, but basically does 25% damage and plus 15% damage resistance. Like I said, these two are much better than the Super Chem Mark 1. Basically, if you equip that, it's just gonna take a spot in your legendary perk section for nothing. It's shit, it's useless, don't waste your time on it. So guys, that'll be it for this video. If you enjoyed, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more content. If you have any questions about this game, feel free to ask me in the comment section. I'll answer all of your comments, and I will catch you on our next video.